I would like to thank the rapporteur for his work on this report. However, as a former nuclear physicist and international negotiator on nuclear security, I believe that the title of this report is strongly misleading. In fact, the nuclear security issue is usually considered as having to do primarily with the specific topic of non-proliferation of nuclear weapons and preventing nuclear terrorism. For instance, there have been four global nuclear security summits, the last one in 2016 in Washington, D.C., which dealt with preventing nuclear arms proliferation and reducing the threat of nuclear and radiological terrorism around the world. The European Parliament resolution of October 2016 on nuclear security also focuses on these specific issues. So if we are to speak seriously on nuclear security in Europe, we should remember the historical experience of defusing Ukraine's nuclear arsenal and lessons that we should learn from it. When the Soviet Union collapsed, Ukraine inherited the world's third largest nuclear arsenal, including about 2,000 strategic nuclear warheads. That is an arsenal which was 2.5 times bigger than that of United Kingdom, France, and China combined. In 1994, Ukraine, along with the United States of America, United Kingdom, and Russia, signed the Budapest Memorandum on Security Assurances in connection with Ukraine's accession to the Treaty on the Non-Proliferation of Nuclear Weapons. Being aware of the existential Russian threat, Ukraine only agreed to give up its nuclear arms in exchange for guarantees of its security and territorial integrity given by the major nuclear powers. Thus, we point out that Russia's aggression against Ukraine undermines the entire global nuclear non-proliferation regime and prompts other states vulnerable to outside dangers to view nuclear weapons as a legitimate way of deterrence against aggression. I emphasize that the Budapest Memorandum's core issue was nuclear non-proliferation. That is the most serious issue for the European and world's nuclear security. What signal does this send to Iran, North Korea, Saudi Arabia, and others? If the international community, including the Council of Europe, does not stand firmly by the Budapest Memorandum, it will fully discredit the idea of security guarantees in defusing nuclear proliferation cases. Dear colleagues, I would like to inform you that now in Ukrainian Parliament there is a draft law on restoring Ukraine's rights for nuclear weapons. Delivering on the commitments under the Budapest Memorandum is the main challenge for nuclear security in Europe. Unfortunately, this report completely neglects addressing this issue and this challenge. Therefore, I cannot support it.